morning students, welcome back you all. This is Sween Gulati, your English teacher from Dakshina Model Senior Secondary School. Today we are going to learn chapter 6, pronoun. So let's open your grammar book, chapter number 6, pronouns, and let's begin with me. Chapter number 6, pronouns. So pronoun, a word that is used in place of one or more nouns. So what is pronoun? A word which is used in place of noun is called pronoun. For examples, I, you, me, he, she, it. Let's take more examples. Rupali is in the kitchen. Rupali is cooking food. So, in these two sentences, what do you see? Rupali, right? Here, the word Rupali is repeated. So, let's take another example. Rupali is in the kitchen. She is cooking food. So, instead of, in the second sentence, we have written she instead of Rupali. So, what is this? She, right? She is a pronoun. Why? Because it is used in place of noun, Rupali, right? It is used in place of Rupali. So, the word which is used in place of a noun is called pronoun. So why do we use pronouns? To avoid the repetition of noun, we use pronoun. Now, let's read about the classification of pronouns. First, we'll read about personal pronouns. Personal pronouns are used in place of names, things, or animals. Means names of people, names of things, names of animals. Personal pronouns are of three kinds. First person, second person, third person. In first person come I, me, we, us. I means singular, we, us, plural. Second person, you, you. In second person, singular and plural are both same. Third person, he, she, it, him, her, they, them. Clear? Now, pronoun must be agree with verb. The most important thing is that a pronoun must be agree with verb. How it is? For example, the pen is broken. Here, the pen is noun. And what pronoun we have used for the pen? Pen is a name of a thing. So, we have used it pronoun. Clear, children? He, she, he is used for masculine. She is used for feminine. It is used for things or animals. So we have used it here for the pen. It is broken. Here it is the singular and therefore we have used is singular verb. It means a verb should be agree with pronoun. Means if we are using singular subject, then we have to use singular verb. Now let's read about the second type of pronoun. Okay, possessive pronouns. Pronouns that show ownership or position are called possessive pronouns. Students, in the previous class, we have studied about possessive nouns, right? What is possessive noun? What is possessive noun? A noun that shows possession or ownership is called possessive noun. Today, we are going to learn about possessive pronouns that show ownership or position are called possessive pronouns. So these pronouns are used in place of possessive nouns. For examples, mine, yours, ours, his and hers. So this car is his. So his is what? Possessive pronoun. Now in place of his we can use like this car is Mohan's, right? This is Mohan's car, right? We can say this is Mohan's car. So this car is his. Now, these toys are theirs. Theirs is possessive pronoun. Clear? Now, we'll read about next type. Now, we'll read about demonstrative pronouns. Pronouns that point at a specific person, place, thing, or an idea are called demonstrative pronouns. Children, the pronouns that point out at a specific person, specific thing, specific place, or an specific idea is called demonstrative pronouns, which demonstrate. Clear? Now, example, this, these, that, those. There are only four demonstrative pronouns. This, these. This is singular. These is plural. So, this and these are used to point out at things that are near us. Things of person also, right? The things or persons that are near us means the things or person which are near to us. And when we are pointing the person or that thing which is near to us, we use this. For example, you can say, this is my bottle. So when the bottle is near to you, you will say, this is my bottle. Next, that, those. That is used for singular, those is used for plural. Now, that, those, to point out at things away from us, means the things or person which are away from us. The person who are away from us, the things which are away from us, means the things which are not near to us. Then we use that and those. For example, those are apples, means the apples which are away from you. Then you will say, those are apples. Now, we'll read about next time. Friends, now we'll discuss about interrogative pronouns. Pronouns that are used to ask questions are called interrogative pronouns. Means the words which we use to ask questions, means the pronoun words, right? So these are known as interrogative pronouns. Example, who, what, which, whose, whom. Whom were you talking to? So, whom. Which is your pen? Which. So these are interrogative pronouns. So children, when you will answer of these questions like, whom were you talking to? What will you answer? I was talking to my friend. So in the answer, what have you used? You have used I. So I is what? It is also a pronoun. In the next, which is your pen? So you will answer, my pen is of green color. My pen is of yellow color. So in answer you have used my. So what is my? My is also a pronoun. I think this topic is clear to you. Let's do an exercise. Students, let's do the exercise. Fill in the blanks with suitable pronouns from the box. It, they, hers, she. Let's read the sentence. Rhea and Priya are in the kitchen, in the market. Dash are buying flowers. So, which pronoun? It, they, her, she. Rhea and Priya. Two nouns. What will we use? They. They are buying flowers. Aman went to the shop, but it was closed. So it has been used for the shop. Right? It was closed. Why we have used it? Because shop is a place. Right? For place we use it. Next. The doll is she or hers? Hers. The doll is hers. It means this doll belongs to any girl. Her, right? Her is used for the female girl. Next. Rhea has a storybook. She reads the stories every night. She is used for Rhea. Clear? I hope this chapter is clear to you. Thank you.